when have you everybody knows about the Taj Mahal. So Taj Mahal was made by a Mughal king, and that was not just Taj Mahal that he made. He made a lot of buildings, and as for the independence, what happened that India and Pakistan and Bangladesh, they got separated. So all those buildings also, they got separated. Okay, Taj Mahal got more famous because obviously it is beautiful and was made by someone for his wife, maybe because of this. But there are many other places also, they are very historical. So this fort is also one of the buildings that was made by the great Mughal Empire. This is Nair Pakistan. It is not that much tall equal to Eiffel Tower, but it is also a symbol of solidarity in Pakistan. And now there are arts and crafts, and for that I would like to ask Shehzad to come and say something.
The Muslim history before the arrival of British into this subcontinent, they compared the rulers of that time was Muslims. So they were very curious to know more about the art, and they were very lovely about the nature. So they were always like to have designs inside the walls and do calligraphies and to do lots of things with the colors. And these are some of the designs that you can find whenever you move to these large buildings. Then there are some portions which you can see that portion was fixed by that person, only for the rulers like kings or governor of that land. So I visited this place so many times. Tomb was found by Shah Jahan. So he designed this tomb specially for the wife of Noor Jahan. And when they were building this land, there was a river just this side of this river, and the name of the river is Ravi. So they built this tomb for her wife, so that she can, there was a place, the room, the right side of this room, and the name of the room is Sheesh Mahal. And that room was totally filled with a different kind of glasses. They specially made for the Noor Jahan. And that the location is very beautiful, that it is suited just like the corner of the river. So the image of to build this tomb was that when the emperor, the king, came to this to the room of the wife, so there is normally a music running on down, and there is a view of river just like to the next side. So my part is just to highlight something about the calligraphy, work. The Muslims were very Muslim rulers were very lovely to their family, so they were very interested to have such kind of color art club, and some of the calligraphy in the religious work is also very common in such part in the person. So some of these calligraphy is to write the name, the first Arabic, the kalma, we call it kalma, I don't know how to say it in English, but the person who cites this kalma is known as a Muslim. So there are so many different calligraphies and so many things. This masjid was also built by the Basham. This is called Bashahi Masjid. And Shahi Qila and the Bashahi Masjid both are situated in front of each other. So this mosque has a capacity to buy 150 kilometers to go inside the place. And some other places, this place now it lost its beauty. the cluster mask, this mask was designed by a Turkish architect. So this mask is situated on these four towers, on these four pillars. This actually, the design is just like they put dig the hose on these pillars, and the height of the hole is just like the height of this pillar. And there is no inside the support for these the floor. This floor is below. If you go inside this mask, there is no. You cannot find anything inside the to support this floor. All this building is supported by these four pillars. And it's another very big mass, more than 300 people can go and to say prayers inside the mass. And the most beautiful thing is that whenever you go inside the mass, the whole building is situated with the marble, the best quality marble inside the mass. And well, actually the temperature of the Pakistan is very, goes very high when it is summer, more than 45, 46 and sometimes 50 degrees altitude. So if you go in on that temperature inside the mask, but the temperature never goes, and the floor is just like the cold. They never feel such heat. And inside the mask, every time there is the air conditioners, and the whole building, the whole the area of the mask is used with the calligraphic words that was written by some calligrapher, and the whole story book is presented in there. And there is an interesting thing is just the center of this mask. If you see, they never mentioned there is a the very large farmers. And there is a very large farmers, very famous. Yes. The palace is situated with more than 1,000 girls, and when they grow this palace, the whole mass is looks more beautiful than
this. Festival and fairs. We have many festivals, just like here we have Carnival and other festivals. We also have other many festivals, just like a religious festival, and some festival we celebrate when the season change. When spring season comes, and when cold season comes, when summer comes, so we have different festivals. So I will explain a little bit. There are different festivals which we have. For example, this is a horse dance, which the season change when spring comes. The people, they have their own melas. Some large number of people, they go to outside their homes, and they have such a melas and horse dances, some good scenes. And these are the people which is called Joshi. Joshi is one of the Kalash, one of the area of Pakistan. The people have a very good dress when the spring comes. So all the area is have a good flowers, and they have a good, they dance in a good dress. And this is a religious festival. All the people, they go to temples, to masjid and mezquitas, and they pray for God. And when they come, they embrace each other. It is a very good part. And these are the Hindi, when someone goes to marriage, they usually decorate their hands with some sort of thing. I don't know Mehendi, it is called Mehendi. And it is called Basant. Basant, the people, when the spring season comes, some city of the Pakistan, all the people have peepas in their hands, they go out and they have peepas, so they are Kathaduri peepas, all the peepas. Okay, they are, this is Basant, all the people, they go and they have peepas in their hand in the spring season. And this is one of the city which have a good dress when the summer season, the spring season comes. They go out, they dance, they have a very good dance, and they have a very good dress. I will show you a small video about these peepas. The people have their own.
They are the tribal area, from the tribal area of Pakistan.
There
is near, actually
near China. They are near China.
They have a totally different culture, different language, everything is completely different. They can't, if we talk to them, they can't understand us.
I increase the sound so everyone can listen a special sort of language. Because my colleague told that we have not one, two or three or four languages. We have more than 50, 60 languages. So the language of these people we can't understand. And they can't, but there is some people which can understand our language. For example, Urdu is the language who all the people of Pakistan know Urdu. But Pashto is one of the languages which we speak in our states. And most of our colleagues, just like my colleague Almas, she can't speak Pashto. My colleague Shahzad, he can't speak Pashto. But they speak their own language, Punjabi. I can't speak Punjabi. But when we meet, we speak Urdu. All the people know Urdu. So, okay, these are religious festivals. Religious festivals, the people, they go to the masjid, the temples, they pray for God, and they pray if they have done some sins during the years, they pray for God that I have done this sins, please forgive me. And when they come out from the mosque, everyone, they hug others. They give abrazo for all the people. Girls for girls and boys for boys. Boys are not allowed to hug girls. Okay, boys are boys and girls, they hug each other. And it is the most important part. For example, sometimes I fight with my friends and I have something in my heart, I don't want to speak with them. But when this festival comes, all the people go to mosque, and when we come out from the mosque, we hug each other. And we know that why I have some sort of not a good relation with my friend. I told, oh, I did something wrong. I'm sorry. During hugging. So after that, all the people become very good and we start a good relation, new good relation. So we have some diets and nutrition. So
I will tell you something about diet and nutrition. As most of the Brazilians here, they have heard the name of halal from most of the Pakistanis conversation. So what is halal actually in Pakistan? As you be a Muslim majority state, so we prefer to eat halal food. And pork and alcohol, they are prohibited, so we cannot consume that. And apart from these two, we also have got some criteria to eat the rest of the meat. And what is the halal meal or halal slaughter? There are two criteria. First of all, the slaughter will only be carried out with an animal that is healthy and without any kind of disease or suspect. And the cut must go through the trachea, esophagus, arteries and jugular veins, so that all of the blood from the animal's body comes out, because blood is something that is not allowed to take in Islam. It has got most a part of urea and stored for health, so because of the health reason, we won't take that. So basically this halal and haram criteria is just for the benefit of mankind in terms of the health purpose. And now let's talk about the national food. We eat pound, Pakistani bread, 3 times a day. And we have different kind of pounds, different kind of breads. You can see we have the one that is the form of, how to say, elongated form, the one which we eat is known as chapati. It's a kind of pound cereal here in Brazil, but it's not exactly pound cereal. This is called naan. Naan bread is more or less similar to the bread that is below pizza here in Brazil. I mean, at some places I ate pizza and I thought, oh, this is the same pound that we use. But we have a lot of varieties. We put many spices also sometimes in this bread. This is a bread that we, there is a small leaf. This is, we call paratha. It's with the oil and we use that in the morning breakfast. And also, like, we use all these pow, you can see with the salad, with the barbecue, with chicken. And what is the method of eating this? I showed this because once I invited my Brazilian friends and I made them, made for them this pow, and they were like, now tell us how to eat. So I was trying to tell them again and again, but it was difficult for them. So I just said that, okay, take the pow, make a kind of spoon from that, and then put this, you know, volume inside the spoon and take it. So this is a way to eat that. It's chicken handi and seal kebab. Chicken handi is a dish from chicken, and handi is the name of this panela. And this is barbecue. All of these, they come with a lot of spices. Like, what is the difference between Pakistan and Pakistani food and Brazilian? Okay, there are many dishes. Maybe the way to cook would be similar. Maybe. But the taste can never ever be similar because we use a lot of spices. So you can see if you go to Pakistan, you can encounter some shops in the market where they sell whole spices. and there are also some shops where they sell spices in the powdered form. And we love so much spices that even, for example, sometimes if we don't have anything to eat in the house, okay, nobody has time to go to the market. So what we can do, we can take the pimento, the green chilies, we give that in a powder, molio, kind of thing that we make from ground chipipo. And then we fry that and we eat that with bimos. This is a kind of very spicy and very famous dish from Pakistan. It's biryani. We make different, make separate rice boiled and then different chicken and make layers and then put colors inside that and we bring out something like this. So if you go anywhere in the Pakistani restaurant or Indian even restaurant, you can ask them to have a plate of biryani, but be prepared, it will be very spicy. So this is the vegetable and salads, kinds of all colorful. One more thing, I don't know here in Brazil exists or not, but there in Pakistan, we have this dish, orange rice, and it's a sweet kind of rice, and we cook that with different nuts and spices. Okay, this is a sweet dish, very famous one. This other one is called jalebi. It's a kind of thing that is made in the form of tubes, and inside those tubes, these tubes, there is a sugar syrup. It's very tasty. This one is gulab jamun. Okay, this was firmly. I made one for one of my Brazilian colleagues here, really like that. And these are the, how to say, those shops are those things. Like you go there and you can ask them, I like, I need 1 kilo, 2 kilo, and they make a pack for you and you can bring for some. Wherever you're going, you can bring to my house also. Okay, now sports and for sports, Akbar,
I always speak about sport. Pakistan is a rich sport country. We play a lot of games in which the famous games are wrestling, hockey, cricket, basketball, kabaddi, squash, and some other games. But I will only talk about the famous game in which we do currently the world champion. Hockey is a national game of Pakistan.